My name's Dylan, I'm a PhD in physics dropout, and instead of finishing the PhD, I realized there were much more important things to do, like making YouTube videos and calculating whether or not the Flash is fast enough to phase through walls. So let's get into it. Comic books regularly feature characters with the ability to walk or phase through solid objects. This superpower is often explained using pseudoscience. For example, the Flash is able to control the vibrational frequency of all the atoms in his body and match it to that of other objects so he can pass through them. In reality, two solid objects are prevented from passing through each other due to electrostatic repulsion rather than a difference in atomic vibrational frequency. In this video, I thought we could work out whether or not his ability to phase through these objects could be explained via quantum tunneling. As in the comic books, we're going to assume that the Flash's body is able to withstand the extreme forces that will arise from moving at near light speed. Let's get into some theory. So Einstein's theory of special relativity basically determined that the speed of light is the universal speed limit. And because of this, we're going to limit the Flash's maximum speed limit to 99% of the speed of light. Also, to simplify the calculations, we'll model the Flash as a spherical particle.
It's hard to say.
All right, the calculations are done, so let's run through it. So you can actually calculate his relativistic kinetic energy with equation 1 up here, okay? So m is the rest mass, c is the speed of light, gamma over here is the Lorentz factor, and you can calculate the Lorentz factor with number 2. So in this equation, v is actually the velocity of the Flash, right? And use v equals 0.99c, the Lorentz factor is 7.089. And then to calculate the probability of quantum tunneling, we have to consider the potential energy of the wall. So the Coulomb barrier, or the electrostatic repulsion, prevents two nuclei from getting so close together that they undergo a nuclear reaction. So this equation here, number 3, right? Basically, K is Coulomb's constant. Z1, Z2 are the atomic numbers of the two nuclei, and R is the distance between the centers of the nuclei. Okay, and inside the nucleus, the potential energy is basically that. So inside the nucleus, the potential energy is given by the nuclear binding energy, but we need to simplify the model. So we only consider the electrostatic potential energy. For a simple case of a constant rectangular potential barrier, the transmission probability is going to be... This video is brought to you by me. This is actually why I've dropped out of the PhD in physics to create this, the world's first consumer post-quantum VPN. So please come have a read, come check it out. I'm really proud of it. We're doing constant work on it. There's a free trial for 7 days, heaps of cool stuff. You should definitely come have a read. It's going to be really important going forward. And this is what the app itself looks like when you load it up on a Mac, Windows, or Linux. So normal VPNs don't currently have post-quantum cryptography, which means they actually can't protect you from powerful quantum computers. Whilst they don't exist, it is going to be a problem because they will be able to capture now decrypt later attacks, which means, you know, if we have them in a few years, hackers could be stealing VPN encrypted data right now to decrypt in like 5 to 10 years. So it's going to be a big problem. You should definitely come have a read, and it would mean the world to me if you could come test it out, have a play, let me know what you think of it. Also creating an AI project which I'm about to launch called AI My Interior, so come have a look in the description. There's a website, you can have a quick sneak peek, and if you put your email in if you want to be notified when I release that one, which will be really soon. And let's get back to the video. Transmission probability is going to be given by this t equals e to the negative 2kl. L is the width of the constant potential barrier, and K equals to the square root of, you know, 2m, you know, parentheses V minus E parentheses over H bar squared. Okay, so don't worry about that. However, equation 3 shows that the potential energy varies with R, all right? So we have to, this K up here, the exponent, we have to modify that to this big boy over here. We'll just call that number 4. So then we integrated equation 4 over the width of the Coulomb barrier, okay? Given that R0 is the radius of the nucleus, and big R here is the outer radius of the Coulomb barrier. That's big R0 as well. So yeah, this big bad boy here, we'll call that equation 5. G is the gamma L factor, right? And X is this big R over big R0 here. Therefore, the transmission probability is this thing down here, P equals E to the negative 2G. So R0 was calculated using the nuclear radius relation, R0 equals R0A to the 1 over 3, which is equal to this thing here, okay? 0.459 times 10 to the negative 14. We're also assuming that the wall is made up of only iron atoms, okay? With the mass number A equals 55.845 atomic mass units. And R is the distance in which the Coulomb potential is equal to the energy of the incoming particle. And that's equation 8 here. So if you didn't know, around 99% of the human body is actually composed of the 3 elements, hydrogen, 65%, oxygen, 24%, and carbon, 10%. And as a result, so we only considered these 3 for calculating, okay? And using the values of R, we can calculate the gamma factor and then the probability of tunneling, and that's all here. And then finally, the average human of about 70 kilograms is composed of approximately 7 times 10 to the 27 atoms, right? Which means there are 4.55 times 10 to the 27 hydrogen atoms, 1.68 times 10 to the 27 oxygen atoms, and 7 times 10 to the 26 carbon atoms. So if the quantum tunneling of each atom is independent from the rest and they're not mutually exclusive, then the total probability equals 10 to the power of negative 10 to the power of 28. And then also, because the human body does not just consist of millions of atoms existing separately by themselves, right? The probability is going to decrease even more if you take, you know, atomic bonds into account. So I just add one thing just to give you some perspective, but I don't think it's going to help. So 10 to the power of negative 28 to the power of 28 is actually going to be 10 to the power of negative this. So that's a very small number. Basically, if you converted, you'd have to convert all of the Earth, the whole Earth, into paper and ink just to write out this tiny number. That's a 0 point
many zeros.
That's how small the probability of the flash quantum tunneling or phasing through physical objects. So yeah, kind of debunked, doesn't make a lot of sense, but hey, it was a fun calculation anyway. It is still possible. I'm not saying it's not possible, by the way. There's a non-zero probability, so it could happen. Wouldn't hold your breath on this tech coming around anytime soon. Maybe in the very distant future. Who knows?